Okay, so the computer just told me the recording is in progress, so let's make it go. As they say in Star Trek, make it so. My name is
Kurt Messick.
Mr. Messick.
Your teacher, Kurt Messick.
Mr. Messick.
Kurt Messick's.
Kurt.
It sounds weird when I say it like that. Kurt Messick's.
Kurt.
I hope that's how I'm pronouncing your last name right.
Kurt Messick.
Hi, Kurt.
I beamed in at Professor Messick's request.
Mr. Messick wanted me to stop by.
Professor Kurt Messick. Hi, Kurt.
And a wonderful teacher like Kurt Messick.
Kurt Messick's.
Kurt Messick.
Your Professor Kurt Messick.
Kurt Messick.
Mr. Kurt Messick.
Kurt Messick, a teacher.
Mr. Messick.
Your Professor Kurt Messick.
Professor Kurt Messick? That is singular.
I'm that Kurt.
Your wonderful teacher, Kurt Messick, or Mr. Messick.
Hello, Kurt.
Hey, students. Listen, Kurt's a great guy.
You're a lovely teacher, Mr. Messick. I call him Kurt, because that's his name.
Kurt Messick.
Yeah, I don't know. Does he let you call you Kurt, or do you call him Mr. K? You call him Mr. Messick, Mr. M? I don't know. I know some teachers don't want to get personal with their students, so they just call me Mr. Messick.
Kurt.
Hello, Mr. Cleese.
Professor Kurt Messick.
Hello, Mr. Messick's class. Keep studying with Kurt.
I really have nothing else to say, Kurt.
Professor Kurt Messick is going to save us all, and he's starting with you guys.
Resistance is futile.
And I will be your instructor during this Earth Science class. We are meeting for 16 weeks, so we will be meeting all through the semester. We will have a spring break sometime in March, but we will be meeting twice a week on Wednesday and on Thursday evenings via Zoom. We will be virtual for the entire semester. I think at one point they thought we might be getting back together again, but I don't think that's the way it's going to be set up. I'll let you know if there's ever any change with regards to that, but I think we can pretty much assume we're going to be virtual during this semester. So that means we'll be meeting on our computers in this way. And one of the things that I want to make clear about that, of course, is that you're still in college. And which college are you going to? You are going to
Ivy Tech Community College.
At Ivy Tech Community College.
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 I took Earth Science at Ivy Tech.
Ivy Tech Community College.
Ivy Tech.
Ivy Tech Community College.
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 Expanding your knowledge at Ivy Tech Community College.
I hope you know my name by now, and I hope you know what college you're going to by now. I hope you know what college you are going to beforehand. But one of the things that all of that stuff may just give you a little hint about is that I will have some celebrities stopping by every now and then, sometimes pre-recorded, and perhaps every now and then I might have someone new. I still have people who are responding to my requests, so you never know who's going to drop by in our class. But we are doing Zoom sessions for question and answer periods. I will, in fact, pre-record the lectures. So I've done this class before, so I have lectures already recorded. I will go through and modify them as needed for our class. Some of the information stays the same. So every now and then you'll see some various clips and some sort of intersplicing in new material. But sometimes it'll be older material. So don't be surprised if my shirt changes or my hair changes, what little there is of it along the way. Certain things you can always count on. For example, you can always count on me to reference Iceland. The northern lights that we have going on here in the background are indicative of that. I'm just weird that way. I go to Iceland quite a lot. In fact, I think we might take a trip there now. one of the things that that video does is it shows you how much you can fall in love with a place. It is just an absolutely interesting place in terms of earth science. And whenever I go there, I stand on different plates. I can put one foot on the European plate and one foot on the North American plate. I've been doing that for decades, and now I can barely hold my feet in the same position that I started with 40 years ago because the plates are separating. We'll talk about that in our class. There are waterfalls, there are volcanoes, there are glaciers, there are northern lights, there are all sorts of things that interplay in the way our planet works. And you can see it sort of in a microcosm in many ways there. The one thing they don't have there are rainforests, but I can go to Seattle to get rainforests. Believe it or not all rainforests are down in Brazil and Africa. We've got some right here in the United States. We'll talk about those different kinds of things too. So I look forward to being with you in our class. I want to talk just about a few things here. Tomorrow, if you're watching this video when I'm making it, or if you're watching it today, our class starts on January 20th. This is also inauguration day. So I'm doing this before the inauguration. So I don't know if lots of things happened or if it was calm and sedate and the way it's supposed to be. We are living in troubled times in different ways, not just the pandemic, but hopefully life will begin to get back to normal, whatever normal is, as we go forward in this. So be sure to wash your hands and wear your mask where it's appropriate. Get your vaccine as soon as possible. I've already gotten the first round of my vaccine because in another life, I am chaplain at a retirement community. So I work face to face with an at-risk population. So I qualified to get the vaccine. I'm still alive. See, no problem. I don't worry about microchips in the vaccine or anything because I've already got that. It's called a cell phone. So, if you think they need chips to go in your blood to track you, guess what? You're carrying it around all the time. They know exactly where you are. Don't worry about that. I will debunk the conspiracy theories because, you know, hey, science, that's what part of what we do in science. Another thing that we'll be doing is we'll be doing things in the Canvas area. The Canvas area is primarily for our purposes in this class, the homepage, announcements, the modules, the syllabus, and the grades, because you'll want to know what your grades are. In particular, I want you to read the syllabus. There are other people who want you to read the syllabus too, like this guy.
A message from Big Snoop D-O-double-G to all these students. Yo, syllabus. You gotta do it. You gotta read it. Man, I'm telling you, the more you know, the further you go. Tell them Snoop Dogg sent you. Syllabus. I know all about it. Catch up so we can have a conversation. Don't be late. Let's go.
Yep, got to read the syllabus. Probably a number one response you'll get from me when you send me a question is, it's in the syllabus. It's in the syllabus. It's in the syllabus. So do get into the habit of checking the syllabus on a regular basis. At the bottom of the syllabus on our Canvas page, you will see, as assignments come up, the assignments and their due dates. So you can keep track that way as well. So remember, homepage, announcements, modules, syllabus. And of course, you'll be just naturally motivated to check out your grades along the way. We do things by points. So pay attention to points, not percentages. If I could turn off percentages in Canvas, I would, but they don't give me that option. The percentage in there is only telling you the percentage of the things you've already done. So don't be misled into thinking at the end of the semester that you have like 98% if you don't have all the assignments in, because when those assignments come in as zeros, that percentage is going to go down. So pay attention to the point level. We go out of 1,000 points, and 900 points will be an A, 800 points will be a B, 700 points will be a C, and so on. And all of that will be laid out in the syllabus as well. This is a difficult time, as I mentioned before. We are living in a time where we have an unpredictability about our health, and about the health of those in our household. And because of that, I'm a little bit flexible on the late policies. Here's the thing. Do not. Did I say do not? Do not. Wait until the last few weeks of the class and then think you can go back in and do week one and week two and week three and week four and week five and week six. No, I will not take it. I will not take it. And what I will do is I will cut and paste this video and send it to you and say, nope, not going to happen. I don't mind if things are a few days late. Doesn't bother me at all because I haven't gotten to grading it yet. So there you go. As long as I haven't gotten to grading it, then you've got no problem. By the time I've already put up a zero in the column because I've gotten to around to grading it, which is usually about 5 to 7 days after it's due. So you've got that kind of wiggle room in there. By the time I put up a zero, it becomes an issue. It's especially an issue if it's something that's supposed to be timely. So if you're doing a lab and then you haven't done that lab before the next lab is due, and that next lab requires the first lab, that's a problem. So there's flexibility, but there's not infinite flexibility. I'm also much more likely to be flexible if you ask me ahead of time. And if we prearrange it and I know what's coming, as opposed to coming in at the end of the semester. I've had that happen. I've had that happen before. I had one guy when we were in a face-to-face class, he was actually in two different classes of mine. He showed up the very first day and he didn't show up again until the last day and tried to hand me a stack of papers. And I just sort of laughed. It's like, no, this is not going to happen. This is not going to happen. He failed both classes. I don't know what he did there or not, but not going to happen. Here's one of the reasons why professors don't do that. It's because that stack of papers, I have no idea how long it would have taken me to grade them. But I know at the end of the semester, I have 168 hours in the week. You know how many hours I have in the week this week? 168 hours. It's exactly the same. 24 times 7 is 168 hours. I can't pick up an unused hour in this week and drop it into that later week so that that later week has 170 or 200 or 300 hours. It still has the same number of hours. I can't grade week 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, all in week 16. There simply aren't enough hours in the day. So that's just the physical constraint. Physics, hey, science. You know, I haven't invented that time machine yet where I can do anything differently. So if you ever encounter professors who are resistant to taking things late, that's really one of the main reasons why. There's simply not enough time in the day or the week to be able to accommodate an infinite number of things. That's why I say, once again, if you plan ahead with me, I can then plan for those hours, which are the same number of hours, to include time, to include your work. So take that to heart, remember that. Again, a few days late here and there, you don't even have to ask. Don't waste the pixels by sending me an email. Just go ahead and do it. If I haven't posted up a grade in the grade book, then it's fair game and you can do it. You will have quizzes each week. You'll have lectures each week. You'll have labs that will run on a 2-weekly cycle. So what I'm going to do for our class, we're meeting for 16 weeks, but I'm going to set it up in 8 modules. So each module will be a 2-week window for you to do things in. So module 1, which will go up right after I do this video, will have chapters 1 and 2. It'll have videos for chapters 1 and 2. It'll have the PowerPoints for chapters 1 and 2, and it'll have the quizzes for chapters 1 and 2. And it will also have some information on your first lab. And that stuff will probably come available on Thursday, because technically our Wednesday, Thursday would be lecture on Wednesday and lab on, or lecture on Wednesday and lab on Thursday. So stay tuned for that. But you'll have at least that 2-week window in which to get things done. You will have a discussion board. These will be very simple check-in kinds of discussion boards. So the first one will be Tell me about yourself. Post up a picture of yourself. Tell me a little bit about your interests. Why are you taking this class? That kind of stuff like that. Hard to go wrong with that along the way. And I'll do the same myself. I'll post up a biographical video. Actually, it's autobiographical since I did it myself. Nobody else did it. I did it myself. And I did it back in the summer, so it references things in the summer. Don't worry about that. I'm still the same guy, basically. So you can, I'm just a little bit older, a little less hair up here, and actually a little less down here. So I look heavier in that video. I lost 50 pounds. I intended to. That was a good thing. I was worried that during our COVID times, I would just sit around at home and eat Mars bars and Milky Way. See, I even have the Milky Way bar here. I have the Mars bar here. Yep, I keep them here. These are actually props for class. So I, turn it upside down there. There's the Milky Way. It wants to, there we go. Milky Way, Mars, Milky Way, Mars. Because, hey, science, astronomy. I also teach an astronomy class there too. You have no idea how hard it is because I love chocolate. I shouldn't do that with the microphone there. Things you learn, things you don't have to worry about in class when you're actually in a physical classroom. It is hard to resist these things sitting here, just waiting to be eaten. But I don't eat them because I need them for props. For these kinds of things. You will notice along the way that there are a number of different things that I will do. We don't always have the Northern Lights in the background. There are all sorts of different kinds of virtual backgrounds that we can have. I like to play around with those quite a bit. So things can get a little bit funky here and there along the way. It just sort of depends upon how much time we have to do things. But you see, I have a green screen back here, so we can get really interesting. We can do things in the Matrix. So here we are in the Matrix. We all live in the Matrix. We can go into video game mode along the way. We can go into outer space in different ways. The NBC Peacock can explode on the back here. But yeah, thanks to the nifty green screen, I have all sorts of different kinds of options that are here. My green screen obviously needs to be ironed, so it's a little bit off, as you can sort of see as you're looking at me right now, and you notice there's a little bit of what's called edging around as I'm doing things. And okay, so every now and then we have some other kinds of weird things that happen for us. But you never know what's going to happen. You never know who's going to drop by when that happens as well. So it is rather fun along the way. This background, by the way, is the replacement for the Hubble telescope that is being built. And you can see how large the reflective panels are on that telescope here. It's been under construction for 20 years. We will be looking at things on Earth. We will also have a bit here and there about astronomy, because I do teach astronomy, and the Earth is a planet. So we'll be looking at how we exist in the solar system, as well as things like rocks, things like clouds, things like lava, things like the mantle of our planet, a little bit of biology, not too much, but a little bit that is involved there. And our labs will also reflect that along the way. So I hope you'll have a good time in the class. I hope you will join me in having a little bit of fun here and there. Just sort of stay tuned. Keep an eye out for what's happening in the world today, because every now and then we will have a sort of breaking news that I will try to bring into the class as best I can. I'll do my best not to put you in jeopardy with any of the assignments. Hopefully they won't be too confusing or too tough. But if it is, be sure to let me know. couple of rules, of course. One of the things is don't Zoom naked in my class. Make sure as you're doing your Zooming that you have your microphone and your camera settings where they need to be along the way. And as you're doing things too, don't mock Father Kurt. I am Father Kurt. I'm actually holier than thou. So whereas most professors can flunk you, I can actually send you to hell. So watch it. But that's okay because I get in trouble myself here. I was crashing the Game of Thrones set on Iceland. Remember the video Iceland there, and they don't take kindly to that. But eventually, they thought it was okay. So I ascended to the Game of Thrones throne. Here. Most people don't last very long there, so hopefully I'll stay there for at least the next 16 weeks. But keep it in mind that this is a class that is meant to be enlightening, and my purpose here is not to find out what's wrong with what you're saying or what you're doing. My task here is to help you. So I will try to be helpful. There are, of course, limits to how helpful I can be and still maintain the integrity of our class. But otherwise, we'll keep on going. We'll keep on going. If you miss assignments, guess what? There is extra credit. I am the king of extra credit. So there will be some extra credit things that will come along. So don't panic. And if I tell you, no, you can't do that because it's too late, it's too far in the past, there may be other points you can come up with later. So stay tuned for that. And otherwise, I hope you have a great day. And I look forward to seeing you first at Zoom on Wednesday, the 20th at 6 o'clock.